Welcome back to the show. It is time for more plastic fun. We've got a retro good time from Atlantis. They sent this over. This is available right now. I will link down in the description where you can snag this for yourself. It is a Tom Daniel creation with new box art from his son. He's been doing Daniel intellectual properties for Atlantis, doing the box arts. We got the Daniel family, we got their kits. We'll be building up all this kind of stuff. The Son of Troublemaker, it is 1/24th scale. It is a fantasy dragster. We're gonna take a look at everything that's gonna be in the box when you get yours. Check out that cool retro box art. They do the old Revell style boxing, lets us know that it will be 8.5 inches long in 71 parts, and it's molded in color. So let's check out the color that it's molded in, see if we're gonna actually need to use paint on this kit. It is molded in a gorgeous deep blue. It's a deeper blue than it actually shows on the camera. The camera lightens it up. It kind of washes out colors like most cameras do. It looks like it has a metallic tone to me by looking at this flat section here. And it is really nice looking. You're going to see the body in a moment, but we've got our chassis, our frame, our engine halves, got our starter and everything molded right in, got our spool molded right in. Remember, these are fantasy dragsters, so they're all about building fun. We got some of our interior body pieces. We've got cylinder heads on here. With 71 parts, there's not going to be a lot to it. We've got our pedal right there. We've got what looks like wheelbacks or inserts. Wheelie bars, something a part of the chassis is mounted on the back there. We've got the other half of the frame on the other tree. We've got some cross members, nice X pattern there. We got a steering wheel, we got dual fire extinguishers. We got our interior bucket, and this nice like tuck and roll style fabric. We could paint that, just that area, another color, or we could paint the whole thing and then paint that. We'll check it out. I kind of like on the box art where the creator did it, the box art builder, did it in red frame. That nice bright red with that body on there with this color plastic. I think that's what Chris is going to go with too. Sometimes you just like the box art. We got our parachutes here. On the back, you can see the steering wheel and the fire extinguishers from the front, steering column, small frame pieces all the way across here. Larger frame braces and pieces over there. That nice frame there. And look at this. Ooh, that is smexy. And I'm digging the flow marks on the plastic. A lot of guys wouldn't like that, but it gives a cool wave to this deep blue, which actually I think brings it out because you get a little bit of lighter, you get a little bit of darker. To me, that's cool. Got the spoiler built in. All the way around the back, you can see a little bit of that color variation. On a light color, that may not be so nice, but this dark color, kind of a mottled, I couldn't do that if I painted it. A coat of future floor polish across this is really going to bring that out. They've got decals for the front end, I think. I don't think they're going to make us paint that, but we'll get over there. We'll take a look. If I saw them on the decal sheet, let's get it out right now. And yes, grill and headlights. So there you go. All done. We got our striping. Son of Troublemaker logos over that deep blue body. That's going to look just like the box art and be really hot. We got Atlantis logos. They've got AFC decals for the wings. Right and left, Wild Wings, window corner. We've got Tom Daniel classic hot rod designs in white there. Speed Shop logos, Tom Daniel logos. Danielle, not Danielle's. I always say that sometimes. 70% of the time I get it correct. The other 45% of the time I get it wrong. Just like I'm not good with percentages. So those are sweet looking on there. We've got a big chrome tree. A lot of chrome. Might want to leave a lot of the chrome alone. Chrome alone, chrome domes. We got our headers here. We got our intakes here. Black wash inside there. We'll bring those out, make them look hollow. We got nice wheel options. Really nice. Molded open. Center lines in the front. Wheelie bars out the back with a black wash on those. Intake and engine parts. We've got a large set of headers which look like they just key into the engine so they can be assembled later. Got those large tabs that go in. Got our outlets, which we can blackwash. Blackwash inside all these grooves on the valve covers, on the timing cover. Nice chrome tree right there. What else we got in the box? We got a clear windshield. It's a little road rashed because it was in there by itself, but future floor polish will bring this right out. You'll see that. We've got a set of tires, not six tires. We've got two-part rear tires, and these always go together real nice. And I haven't even clipped anything off. These go on the inside anyways, so that's the outside that you see. If you want to buy some tire decals from folks at Model Roundup, some Gopher tire decals, those will look sweet on there. Model Roundup does carry these, as well as Atlantis Direct. Then we've got some front tires, no names on the front. Nice bias ply tread. They're fat for a dragster. Gonna put those center lines in there. And that is it. The manual is a standard old school, what I'm gonna guess is monogram manual. Nice large print. Big details for us old farts with bad eyes. No tiny drawings. They look lovely on there. They even give you some advice. Please sand down the bottom of the oil pan to allow for more clearance. So if that giant sump down there is an issue, you could cut it off or sand it down to get it to fit maybe without hitting between the rear wheels. And that is it. Then they got the decal guide inside, and you can follow the box for more ideas. I'm going to get the glue in mine together, and we'll be right back. Thank you. There really is not a lot to do to assemble Son of Troublemaker. It's going to be a very easy two-day build, I think. We're going through things. I've got the chassis glued together. I did use some super glue to hold things together. It is a little tweaked. The frame rails are a little tweaked when they were molded, probably pulled out of the mold really quick when they were hot or something. So I did straighten things out as best I could. We're going to see how it all lines up in the end. It looks like I'm going to be okay, and it looks like it's going to sit fine, but we'll see as we go. I'll let you know. We've got the frame glued together. The seat pretty much is what holds this frame lined up. And then we've got smaller frame rails. Everything has a locating hole, not just, and some have actually tabs and stuff like that. So it's not gonna be something where it's really difficult to put together and freaks you out and all that. Every bar, every part of the steering and the pedals and everything all has its place on the model. I'm going to try to reach in there after I paint all of this and get it together. We've got our cross members assembled in there. We got all this nice work in there, all going together and looking good. We got where the body locks on the front and rear and everything, and that is a sharp looking assembly. So we're going to get that painted up in all one color and then detail paint it. Same with the engine and the spool and the cylinder heads. We'll get this painted one main color so I can get it all on there. Then I will go in and pick out my individual colors and make it stand out on its own. But that's just, what is that, four pieces each have, and the cylinder heads. The rest, a lot of the timing chain, the intake, stuff like that, are all custom chrome pieces that we'll be putting on and trying to texture those as well. All these parts here can get attached later. We've got fire extinguishers, parachutes. Parachute's going to go on the back of the body. The steering wheel can get attached. That can get put in there later. The fire extinguishers can get attached later. And this holds up the back of the body. We will stick it in here, we'll get it painted its own color, and then we will get it all attached in the back on that tree there. We've got our magneto slash distributor that needs to be painted. We've got our fuel tanks. Those are chrome, and I left them chrome. I glued them together. There's a little bit of a blue nub here from cutting them apart. I'll just do that with a chrome marker. And that's ready to go. I wanted that assembly to be chrome, especially the fuel tanks. You saw me assemble these tires. I mean, it is kind of hard to tell unless you can see the shiny glue on the inside. That's just contact cement. It's like a silicone rubber cement. So I know it works on these tires. I did not try model glue. I didn't even read the instructions if model glue works. I don't use it on these. Even when they say model glue works on tires, two-part, it never seems to hold as well as a rubberized, like a shoe goo, silicone caulk, anything that clear glue compound, rubber cement will work well. And this is the outside of the tire anyways, so that's going to look just fine once we get our tire pressed in. You're not going to notice this lip around here. If I put it in the machine and sand it down, it's going to look even better. So that's how those two are put together. Super easy, and that will dry overnight. The body just needs some parts installed, like the body lock, these panels inside, which I wrote their numbers on them. You won't be able to see that once the body's on, and you'll be able to see just the lip. So I put the numbers on the inside. You'll be able to see a little bit of the fender when you lift the body, but that otherwise will be hidden. And then this is the tilt mechanism right here that I glued in. And that clips onto the front because this body comes up in the back. So that's interesting and different, and that's what I like. The engine's in the back, that'll come up. The driver can get in on all that. None of this is gonna get painted. This is just gonna get decaled as is, and then we're gonna brush some future floor polish on it and see how well it shines, and I bet that thing is going to look yummy like a big blueberry. We've got our chrome parts tree here. All I did with that is I glued in the blue wheels. Now you can press those in if you want your car to roly roll on the floor. I don't, because every time I move it, then it goes rolling off and breaks and I cry, and it's just a bad day. So I glued those in with super glue. The wheels look nice as they are. The intake, I'm going to see what we can do with some of these metal parts here. Normally I would spray it, but there's so many on here and I'd have to cut this part and hold that little part. I've got some brush on Del Coat. I don't know if it's going to work as well as spraying, but we're going to find out in this video. So that's what I'm going to do for some of the wheels and stuff. We're going to see for the headers, the intake, I'm going to leave chrome for sure because those velocity stacks are almost always chrome, but we'll see what we can do with that. We'll experiment a little bit, and that's what model making is about. So I'm going to get this stuff, not that and not that, I'm going to get just that stuff into paint, and I'll be right back. before I can call this kit done. All I have to do now, after gluing everything together, you saw how easy it glues together. I glued on all those chrome pieces, and they all have locating pins and marks that actually work, and the holes are open. So I was able to do that entire nose and steering and everything all the way back to the steering column with just drops of super glue. And the wheel and tire package pushes together. You might have to use a little bit of glue inside the wheels. Mine did press together, though one of them did fall apart, and I just had to press a little harder, but otherwise they held well. And I think using that Dull Coat turned out quite well. And it sits on all four tires. It's not all wickety-wackety. Usually with a two-piece chassis, I have a heck of a time, but this one went together nice. I painted the fire extinguishers a safety yellow instead of red. I wanted them to stand out from the chassis. Then I just reached in and did the seat in a basic black. Got our fuel tanks out in the front in chrome. Got our steering linkages, everything, and the wheels. Then we have our headers. You saw how easy those zoomies just, I mean, they just plugged right in. And the engine goes into the chassis with our transaxle in the back and the body prop here. Now, what I did on the body prop was, it seemed like once this was all glued together, the body prop was too wide for the spacing here. The bar that was in the middle was actually a U-shaped. Instead of trying to cut that and splice it together, I just removed it entirely. The tension holds it in just fine, so I don't need that, and it actually, I like how it looks with that there. Plus, it doesn't interfere with the body lock in the back when the body goes on. So that is it. The chassis is all done. It's got a nice weight to it in that scale. The body needs all of its dress up, and I've been looking at the decals. The Troublemaker's all one piece. The hood is even all one decal. You can see when the glare goes across. We got our grills and our headlights. The sponsor decals across the bottom, those are all one long piece, which is excellent. You don't have to sit there and try to place seven decals along the bottom and drive you up the wall. So that will go right across the bottom. Though, as you can see, what I noticed and you'll want to see is you're going to have to cut off something from each side because they're longer than the body is long, unless you move them up higher. So if you want to put them on that bottom lip right in front of the zoomies, kind of like the box art has, see how it is on the box art on the very bottom? That's not going to work because it's not long enough. So it's not a huge issue. You just have to move them up on the body if you want them all, but I will just cut off some and put them on mine, or they're simply not going to be, they're going to be too long. You can fit, it looks like five of them instead of seven along that lower trim piece. We got the Atlantis decals. We got the Tom Daniel decals. Apply them as you wish. We can see the body. I painted that bumper a metallic look like they do on the fiberglass bodies so that it wouldn't contrast with the headlight buckets. The headlight decals will go in the center. We got our grill decal. I colored in the turn signals and glued on the parachutes in the back. We are ready to go. After I get the decals on and they are completely dry, the body on the inside of the glass, the outside of the glass, and the entire body will get two coats of future floor polish. Then we will attach it to the chassis and we will have our final. Son of Troublemaker, a Tom Daniel design is done. The 454 powered El Camino is one heck of a cool ride. The body just snaps onto those hinges in the front, and that body closer that we showed you in the building goes on the back, and look how nice that sits. Now, I did not have to shave anything off that oil pan in the back on mine. There is maybe a half a millimeter between that oil pan and the ground. Something I was amazed that worked right out of the box was the velocity stacks and the zoomies come out in the right position on the body. They're not off-centered. They're not too far forward. I didn't have to shave anything or cut anything. And the zoomies fit in the right spot. The decals laid down beautifully. They are very, very thin. I use my standard decal application. You can see it in other videos. They laid down and dried up nicely. I did not use one drop of decal solvent. That's how smooth these are. I didn't think I would, because after doing that Atlantis jet and seeing how thin those decals were, I figured, well, let's not try any decal solvent. They might wrinkle up on me like they did on the jet. And I didn't use it, and they came out beautiful. The whole kit goes together quite easy. Sits on all fours, as you can see. I, of course, chose my own details. I did do the decals a little different. I wanted the Atlantis logo on the back, and I wanted the Tom Daniel logo towards the front, right behind the engine. I wasn't looking for it on the corners or above the fenders. I put the Speed Shop decals where they have them above the front tires. I put them on the rear quarters instead, on the back of the box. I didn't use any of the white decals except for the AFC logos, and I put it on the windshield and the side window. They have it on the side window and the spoilers. I put it on the windshield and the side window. You can see the entire cockpit inside the driver's area. That looks awesome. The window trim looks great with a little silver on it. I love that there's open vents in the engine. You can detail this any way you want and build it up your way. When you lay your decals down, you decide if you want to copy Tom Daniel's design, the Atlantis design, or if you want to go your own way. The only contingency decals I used were along the bottom. I really wanted to leave the body as clean as possible with just some very simple logos. They look nice, they went on easy. We can see the nose, we got our headlights in, and our grill. That makes the work a lot nicer, and I didn't have any fighting or problems with getting that body on. I will display it in some of the pictures with the back tilted up, so you can see what it looks like, and we'll do a couple pictures with just the chassis. I thank Atlantis Model and Toy and Hobby for sending this over. This is in stock right now at Atlantis. It's in stock at Model Roundup. I will link to both depending on your purchasing preference, or you can get it at your local hobby shop as always. I want to thank everyone for your support of the show and enjoying these fun model kits. You can see how gorgeous that body is, and the only paint is really the front bumper, and then I use the Sharpie marker for any other details on the kit, and it just comes out absolutely awesome. I did paint the chassis because I like the red on the box art and everything inside there. I agreed with that, except I did it in a darker metallic red instead of a bright red, and the kit will come out looking fantastic whether you choose to paint the body or just clear coat it like I did. Thanks for watching the workshop. Always appreciate your nice comments, your subscriptions, your likes, and we will see all of you at the next review.